I have spent a lot of time battling my ego, and I just noticed that maybe there's a healthy side to the ego. Is this true? I love that question because, again, we've talked so much about no judgment, no guilt. And if there wasn't a healthy side to the ego, then the idea that only love is real couldn't be true. You know, the graduation statement and knowledge of A Course in Miracles is only love is real, the Bhagavad Gita. Any big, powerful, important sacred text really highlights only love is real. So anything else is an illusion. So we have these egos. If only love is real, then what's the loving perspective of an ego? It's that when we have an ego, we can see ourselves as separate from the divine enough to have an adventure known as planet Earth with human beings and human bodies. So, as long as you're in a body, you have an ego. As long as you can see yourself as having a body and that body over there is someone else and that body over there is someone else, then you have an ego. As long as you have two eyes, two ears, this is the world of duality, there's a this and a that, then that is the ego because that's separate from oneness. So, yes, there is absolutely a valuable aspect to the ego because if we chose this adventure consciously, now have it be more like an adventure in consciousness. If we choose to have an adventure wherein we think ourselves separate from God and then want to feel what that would feel like, then this is an amazing situation. The only way to return to awakening while you're in this physical body thinking you're separate is to identify all of this, all of this, all of everything in the world as love, or in the world of duality, a call for love. So the only answer is love, and that'll get us back home. But in this world where we have egos that are wanting to, you know, in A Course in Miracles, it says, we had a temper tantrum in which we said, I wanted thus. That's this whole world of separation that actually had happened in an instant. What would it be like if I was separate from God? Instant. And then it dragged out through millennia in our time and space awareness. And so this is all done. It's already happened. We're already back in the heart of God. But in this dream of separation, having a body is really valuable to experience this. And seeing someone else over there that I can have an argument with and then choose love to come back to and have a this and a that and have a way far flung experience from who I truly am as divine and then come back to me and come back to my heart and be at one with the love that I am. That's a massive and amazing experience to have. So the value of the ego is letting us be capable of having any experience whatsoever of separation. You know, there's a beautiful Hindu saint, Anandamayi Ma, and Anandamayi Ma means bliss permeated mother. She was in this state of bliss pretty much most of the time. And she was happy to be in that state, to be able to adore the divine as separate from her. But she was so close that she was almost breathing the same breath as the divine. And people would come just to sit in her presence and to be there in her light. I was fortunate enough that they have all of her transcripts of all of her talks and her actual audio tapes of her talks and videos and things of her archived in the Harvard archives. And so when I was there, I was able to spend time in the archive rooms, just me and this huge cart they wheeled in with all of Anandamayi Ma pictures, things that many people have never even seen before, and just be in that world of bliss permeated mother. And I'll tell you, you know, that is a beautiful aspect of having an ego. To be that close to the divine, to be that close to love, but not be taken into it, to be at one with it. So there's still an experience that you're having in a human body in form. So I love the question again. I've spent a lot of time battling my ego, and I just noticed that maybe there's a healthy side to the ego. Is this true? Beautiful question. And another thing about that is one of the ways that I ultimately woke up was towards the end of a very challenging journey of battling my ego for so long. I realized that the ego was like a puppy. You know, why am I battling this? It's doing what it does. It doesn't know any better than to try to keep me separate. It thinks that that's what it does. And it's running around and ripping papers and peeing in the corner and doing things that you want to just strangle it when you start to realize, oh, my ego just popped up again, or you feel guilty or judgmental. And when I realized, it was like a little puppy, just embrace it. And then I realized I could just do the opposite of whatever the ego says to do. If it says to me, fight with someone or be right here instead of being wrong, just relax. Just see it as a call for love. Don't see it as something to battle. See it as an experience and an opportunity to know yourself as non-judgmental and not to have to be guilty. Let yourself see it like a little puppy. It doesn't have to run your world. And at the same time, it allows for you to imagine that you have a human body and everyone else has human bodies and you're separate from them. And it lets us see that this world is lacking without the divine, transfused and imbued in everything.